Dear students, now we have to do the reading of the lesson. You know, reading is, does it mean the translation of the lesson as we did in first year? Because here in second year there would be no translation. It is just the hunting of the synonyms and short questions. So wherever there will be a synonym, I will tell you that, and wherever we come across a short questions, I will point out that to you. So we just learn the both things, synonyms and short question, during our lecture. A few stars are known which are hardly bigger than the earth. Hardly mean scarcely. A few stars are known which are hardly bigger than the earth. The most of them are so large that hundreds of thousands of earth could be packed inside each. There are a few stars which are scarcely bigger than the earth. And there are such a stars, some stars are so large that hundred and thousand earths can be packed inside each, and even then they leave space. Room means space. Here and there we find an immense star large enough to contain a million and millions of worlds. The stars which we see daily are immense. Immense mean large, big, huge. They are so big that they can pack millions of Earth inside them. And the total number of stars in the universe is probably something like the total number of grains of sand on all the seashores of the world. So don't think that you can count the stars which you see in the sky at night. They are countless. They are so many in number as there are the grains of sand on the seashores. So we can't count the grains of sand in the seashores. Similarly, we can't count the stars. Such is the littleness. Such is the littleness of our home and space when measured up against the total substance of the universe. Substance means matter. When we compare our Earth, our universe, with the space, with the total mass, with total mass of the universe, so our Earth, our universe is so small, is so short. So this is creation of Allah Almighty. As we know that the stars are in millions, they are so countless that can't be counted. So these millions of stars are wandering about in space. These so many stars, where they are? They are moving in space. Wandering means roaming. They are roaming in space. A few form groups which journey in company, but most of them travel alone. Some stars move in the form of groups. They make companies, but most of the stars, many among them, they move along. Here we are discussing the question number one given in the exercise of your book, that is, how is it that a star seldom finds another star near it? This is the question, that how it happens that a star rarely comes near the other star. So answer to this question we are reading now. And they travel through universe so immense that it is very, very rare even indeed for one star to come anywhere near to another. When they travel, there is a distance of billion miles between them. So that is the reason that it doesn't happen that a star comes near the other star. For the most part, each star makes its work in complete loneliness. What happens? That every star travels in loneliness, like a ship on an empty ocean. As there is a ship in an empty ocean. When we see a ship in an empty ocean, there is just a ship. Nothing is around. Same is the case with a star. It also moves in space like that ship, around which there is just an ocean, just a water of ocean, nothing is inside it. In a scale model in which the stars are ships. The obvious ship will be well over a million miles from its nearest neighbor. The distance between, if we make a map, if we take a scale model, and here we symbolize ship as a star, so there would be a distance of million miles between one ship to another. Same is the case with stars. From this, it is easy to understand why a star seldom finds another anywhere near it. So now it is easy to understand why a star rarely comes near the other star. Students, you know your question. That was, how is it happened that a star seldom finds another star near it? It is just because that there is a star travel in complete loneliness. There is a distance of million miles between them. This is the reason that a star seldom finds another star near it. I hope you would have learned this question. Why a star seldom finds another star near it? Because there is a distance of million miles between them when they travel around the sun.